for another episode of After Class. We got Aliya up in the building, say what's up. We got Jazz up in the building, say what's up. We got Honey up in the building, say what's up. We got Isaac up in the building, say what's up. He's the newest character to After Class because, you know, he's running our audio, making sure that we don't got no hiccups.
Yeah.
You know?
Y'all don't get to see what Isaac looked like, though. That's going to be a reveal in the finale.
Yeah. People just love his voice.
He in this shot. Just blur him out.
Blur it.
Soft focus.
Blur it.
Shallow depth of field.
Change the camera angle.
On the C cam.
Change the camera angle.
So, y'all, if you're watching this, YouTube video, I have this it is so hot in here, you guys. Let me just let y'all know where we're at. So, we went from Ghetto Productions. We went from the red couch to the professional studio, and we're the first show to be up in here.
Yeah.
So this building is not even like open. Set up yet. Like, there's no furniture. Yeah, it's not open. There's no furniture. There's no AC, bitch.
It's hot as hell.
So obviously, you know, my fucking sweaty ass is sweating up a storm in this motherfucking corner.
So y'all can't see.
But. Yeah, she has coochie sweat. I have boob sweat.
Great.
So I'm using Tallie's jacket. If you're watching, I'm using Tallie's jacket to like cover up my armpit stains.
I think you should
just to make
free.
It a little better.
Let the people
bitch,
know.
I was free last episode. I was sweating up
your
a storm
people
last,
know
last
you be
episode.
Sweating. They done seen your classes. They done seen your
we
booty
do be
sweat,
having coochie
your crotch
sweat, booty
sweat. Yeah, they done seen it.
And
I know, but just to be,
to
if I was dancing, it would make sense. But for me to just be sitting in it, that's just kind of different. So let me live my life. I have this Armani Exchange jacket all up and through these armpits to, you know, cover it up.
That's my jacket, by the way.
We sweat in style.
That I bought for him for Christmas.
As a gift. So I'm just going to take everything back that you gave me and use it how I want to use it then. How about that?
Why are you trying to do this Isaac voice?
I'm using my Isaac Carter voice, y'all. Today's the day I'm using my Isaac Carter voice.
I'm like, why are you using this R&B Isaac voice? Come on, baby.
Yeah.
Show him the real voice. Show him the voice that I love.
Ain't this in it?
Anyway, so you know, I have, so Isaac and Tallie actually know each other, y'all. They've been, how long have y'all been friends?
We are brothers, actually. We went to FAMU. I came up in 2002. When did you come up?
2008.
So yeah. we were at FAMU, for a year, and then I left. I did America's Best Dance Crew in 2009.
Yeah.
But we're frat brothers, our music fraternity, Phi Mu Alpha.
Mm-hmm. Really?
Yeah, Chapter Brothers, Omicron Gamma.
You know wait, deadass?
Yeah, deadass.
I didn't know you was Greek.
Yeah,
bitch, which is what I want this episode to be about.
That's why I'm slow.
Yeah, we did Coachella.
Stupid.
We did Coachella together out here, and you know what I'm saying? But, you know, Marching 100, that's what got it all started. FAMU, stand up. Tallahassee was good.
You did the inauguration, too.
Nah, I was on ABDC. That was the... That was when I got that camera time, because I told them that I was going to be at the inaugural parade, and I wasn't going to be there.
Mm-hmm.
It was too cold in D.C.
Too cold.
We're going to give a shout-out. I realize we just didn't... We didn't even...
Ari.
Sis. Yeah, Ari. Oh. Sis is not up in the building... Once again for this episode. But say what's up,
sis.
What's up, Ari?
Shout out to sis. What's up, Ari?
I can't. I will never get over it.
We will not get over your voice, Isaac.
I'm gonna turn my mic off.
No.
Anyway.
Can you turn my bass up? Can you turn my bass up?
I'm fucking crying.
I got too much treble.
So, honey, what do we got? What catch us up on things, because the people haven't seen you in a little bit since like the second or third episode. So catch us up on what's been happening.
I mean,
I
with me, yeah,
since
like
sex talk. You know the camera's on you, right? Yeah, the last time, honey, was in the show. Our audio was so bad. Isaac, don't even look. Our audio was so bad that episode.
Booty.
So now you can clearly hear Tallie, but we were talking about sex. We were talking about faking it. Isaac,
have you ever faked it?
Yeah, have you ever faked it while having sex? Like
fake the orgasm or?
Oh no, nah, I don't believe in faking.
Oh shit! So you just be looking at them like, bitch.
What if it's not good? You're just gonna stick with it.
Me?
Yeah.
Like, me fake it? Or are you saying reaction to them faking it?
Have you ever faked it while in the act?
No.
Oh, so you just had all good partners, basically?
No, I wouldn't say that.
So what did you do? Yeah, so what'd you do when you
he
had
got
a bad
his.
Partner?
He got his.
Oh, you made it. He went till he got it, bitch. He said it's trapped.
Hey, we just don't make gonna make it work.
No, I mean, there's I try to be cautious of who I mess with like that.
Okay.
If I
he don't even get himself into that situation.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I try to understand the vibe before it even get there. You know what I'm saying? Right. And if it do get there, then...
Well, yeah, what if it do get there?
My antennas was off that night.
That's what we're asking. If it do get there, what do you do in that situation when you realize, like, this shit is not it?
Wow.
Oh, I would just stop.
Oh, okay. Cute.
I would just stop. Okay. I'll just be like, you know...
Ball this game. Ain't it.
Just call
ball game.
Just
call it.
You got to call a spade a spade.
I called the ball game. I just acted. Acted my way out.
Honey,
wait,
it's a different story.
We're tweaking something. Go ahead. Keep talking real quick.
Y'all got to find.
Yo, check. Yeah, turn my bass up. There it is. You hear the rumble? The rumble. There it is.
Oh, God,
see, that's
honey.
Why my voice wouldn't. See, his microphone is different than mine. That's why his voice sounds deeper than mine.
He said it was the equipment, bitch.
It's the equipment.
Back to Ghetto Productions.
Back to Ghetto Productions. Honey, give us a catch up. What's been happening? Even though we live together and we know everything about each other, tell the people.
Okay.
Anything to catch up on?
Y'all know COVID's been doing this thing. Me, I've been expanding myself. You know, I expanded into a lot of people are aware of this now, but foreign exchange, if you're not familiar with the foreign exchange market,
what
I'm saying?
It's
dealing with finance and stock market and stuff like that. I've actually taken a liking towards that. I've been on my own, learning on my own. I follow a couple of different groups that I train. So that's been good. That's been great. Take this time to, you know, do something outside of your comfort zone. And, man, I have had...
Sorry.
I've had 3 deaths in the family. You know, to keep it light... It's been interesting because each one was a build to the next one. Like, each person was a little more, like, you know, important to me. So just recently, first I lost my biological father. Great relationship there. We hadn't been too close, but, you know, there was love lost. You know, I mean, there was love there, and that was bad. I mean, that wasn't the best. And then my grandfather passed. That was a little deeper, but he was up. He was 91 years old, you know, lived a good life, you know what I'm saying? And then... Just recently, very tragically, my stepdad passed away.
That one
hit me out of nowhere.
Father figures.
Yeah, I've lost, I had, in my life, immediately, I had 4 fathers. My Uncle Kenny, my dad, my grandfather, and my stepdad. I lost my Uncle Kenny years ago. He was probably the closest one I was to. And then I lost these, but I don't look at them in complete losses because... Now, like, each one of them has, like, a certain energy or something that I tap into when I need to, like, step up, you know what I'm saying, when it's something, you know what I'm saying? So not to get into it too deep, but, you know, when you have your loved ones that left you, if you had a good relationship with them, whatever the color of that relationship that was the height or the thing that made you feel good, I just use that as the memory with them. So that's been me. It gave us the opportunity to connect with family.
I know. See,
you know
coming out of the crib, I didn't even know.
What's so different about him is I would probably be, I think any normal person would just be, they would have shut down.
Yeah.
They would have shut down. Tallie probably had a night to kind of let his feelings go and be emotional. But after
you
that one night, he bounces back so fucking quick from, like, just any death or any tragedy that happens. When someone would normally just shut down for weeks, bitch.
No, dead ass.
For fucking
I'm
weeks.
I'm in shock. Like,
Tallie, yeah, I know. He's
silent,
like,
bitch.
How is he even talking like this? For
right.
real. Yeah. You know, Tallie is just like of a different breed, and he can just bounce back. And it's so cool how you think of
that.
You
death. Know what else hit me surprisingly hard? Well, you know, but Chadwick Boseman.
Yeah.
Like, it was tough when he passed, but I didn't think I would get as emotional as I actually did. I actually cried. And I think just when you're talking about artists and connecting, like, he's a person that I've always seen a lot of similarities and the choices that he made and his character and
you
all
these
kind of things.
Honey.
Like, I seen that through and through or whatever.
There's so many
similarities. You know, I had wishes of working with him one day. You know, I think that's probably why it got a little deeper to me or whatever. You know
walking
what
that legacy.
Plus for what everything that he stood
for,
you know
real.
What I'm saying? Black Panther and everything. Hey, yes, it's just a character, and yes, that's a movie,
that
but it
so
means a lot more energetically
yeah,
for that figure. So, you know, shout out to him and his family. Shout out to my families and everybody who's lost. Everybody has lost people, you know, some
so
tragically.
So what would you say to somebody who's maybe dealing with a loss of a family member, either from COVID, you know, due to COVID or due to, you know, old age or whatever. What would you say to them? Like, just words of wisdom. Like, how would we get through it? What would
Let's
you say
see.
To them right
well,
now?
Well, the first thing is it's okay to grieve and it's okay to release, because especially black men and men in general, we get into that habit of like, you don't cry tears of weakness, but when you hold that energy in, it does not turn into anything good.
Yeah.
You know, so it manifests in other ways, physical injuries, relationships, how you treat other people. So that grieve, you got to get it out. Talk about it. Make sure that you get everything said. Don't do the, I'm going to find distractions. Those distractions have their place, but at some point you got to address it or it's going to come back up at some point.
Mm-hmm.
And then the second thing is to find your light. Find that person is now an angel on your shoulders. You know what I'm saying? And if they are a demon on your shoulders, then it's time for you to exercise that demon. It's time for you to release, forgive, let them go. Mm-hmm. You can't do anything more to them. They can hurt you more than you can hurt them. They're gone. They're on the other side.
Mm-hmm.
If you keep them in your mind and let them live in your headspace, then you get to suffer from whatever was done to you for the rest of your life or whatever. So easier said than done. You got to get over that. Find the light. Find the beauty. Whatever that person represented to you, amplify that. And every time you think of that good thing or you need some encouragement, pull from your ancestors. Pull from the people who've gone before you and, you know, just have your own connection.
Period.
Yeah. That's helped me and you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No, it really has. Yeah. But on a lighter note, everybody, on a lighter note, I wanted to, since Sis wasn't able to join us again, I wanted to obviously bring Honey up in the building because these three, Jazz, Isaac, and my Honey, they are all Greek, bitch.
I
Gang. Wait, I probably shouldn't cuss when it's a reference to my letters.
Ah, it's all good.
Edit out.
So, okay, so for someone, y'all, for someone who doesn't know what, like, being Greek is, can someone please explain to me what that is?
Isaac, go.
We want to hear your voice, Isaac.
He got the Black History voice.
Right. Low key.
In a nutshell, a Greek organization is a brotherhood and or sisterhood, right?
Mm-hmm.
Usually involves a group of people that go through some sort of rite of passage to develop some type of camaraderie. But I will say this, there's also a business aspect to it, if that makes sense.
Divine Nine is different than the college sororities.
Yeah.
I mean, yeah, there's a, like, I'm not Divine, I'm not D9, right? So,
another term that I don't know, another term that we don't know.
Right.
What is
D9? So to break it down, there's, let's just talk about fraternities and sororities across the board, right? So, a lot of colleges and universities have fraternities and sororities, right? And then there's kind of like these subsets, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
Or different categories. So you have like service fraternities that focus on certain things, like
like different clubs and shit, right?
Then like social fraternities, like I'm not in KK Psi, but we know a lot of people that are in KK Psi, which is a service fraternity
for the band.
They step in all that, but it's like mainly about them providing service,
right?
To the
what
band.
They do,
you know what
right?
And
right.
We're a professional fraternity. Phi Mu Alpha is
a professional social fraternity.
Yeah, so we are music based. There's fraternities for doctors. There's fraternities for pharmacists, nurses.
Mm-hmm.
You know, they have different ones for different areas, and then just the social ones, the ones that are more popular, the Divine Nine.
Yeah,
you know,
Mega Psi
Phi. You got Alpha Phi Alpha, AKA the Deltas, SG Rose. You got the Iotas, you got the Zetas, you got
the major historically black
Kappas.
Did organizations Kappas? Are the
no.
D9.
No. I mentioned them.
Okay, so I think for a viewer, for people who are watching, I think when I think of fraternities and sororities, I think like Stomp the Yard, Drumline, right? No?
Ooh. I mean, it's a way to think of it, but they're just a lot deeper.
Mm-hmm. No, and that's what I definitely want to touch on, but just on a surface level. You know what I'm saying? For someone who like literally does not know not one thing about it, you know, and I think like 90% of the people who are listening right now and watching, they have no idea. So I'm like, let me just put a picture into their head.
Yeah.
Okay. Right. Yeah. Is there any other movie maybe that I'm missing that kind of where we can kind of just like go and think?
It's just a tough,
paint an illustration.
The illustration would be Stomp the Yard. The illustration would be School Days. Again,
school days is maybe a parody.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But it's a little bit closer, I think, because it kind of shows that, like, you have funny things that go on and you have, like, the rivalry between some fraternities.
And then there are some serious issues interlaced.
Let's not forget, though, we know that there's fraternities, the organization, and then there's chapters. So the chapters are by the school and location.
chapters, mm-hmm. regions, mm-hmm. national. Oh, Lord.
So there's a, it's a lot. Of, there's a, there's a, it's, they all have a pyramid. It's a business and a pyramid. Yeah.
I want you guys to let us know what fraternity or sorority you guys are a part of.
Alpha Kappa Alpha Sorority Incorporated, founded in 1908. Thank you. Skiwi, skiwi, skiwi. I'm not going to fully skiwi, bitch, because it's a little loud up in here, but
I want to hear it. Do it. Oop.
I got to do it in a little bit. I got to prepare my vocal cords.
All right. Just once when you feel it, just go. Just interrupt.
Period. Just go. Okay? Y'all going to hate me, bitch.
Isaac, what fraternity are you a part of?
So I am in Phi Mu Alpha Symphonia Music Fraternity of America. Mm-hmm. My dad is an alpha, so shout out to the K's. I didn't have the opportunity. Well, I had the opportunity that got suspended, but that's a whole other conversation.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
So that's anyway.
Right. Gotta keep it with them topics.
Yeah, so I did that and then a couple other like organizations across campus.
Okay. Some underground stuff. So there's underground and above ground stuff.
Yeah. Honey. We're going to talk about above ground.
All right, let's do the above ground. Let me run
the
list.
Honey has a whole motherfucking list.
If we're going that way, then I got a lot of list. Yeah, you got a lot of okay, all right.
We'll get into that. But we're also we're brothers in the Omicron Gamma chapter of FAMU Alpha. That's FAMU, and then I'm a part of the Mighty Melodic Bloody Up Upsilon side chapter of Omega Psi Phi at Florida A&M University.
Dang, Bumpy
Johnson,
because
I run the city. Spring
entry.
08. What's up, Ace Dog?
You'll go.
Dang, yeah. I didn't do my nothing. Spring 17 Trade Club, Lovely Lambda Alpha. Dang, I didn't know we was doing all that. You need to hire me.
And then I'm also a charter member of the Omicron Delta Kappa Chapter, Honorary Leadership Society.
He's official,
amongst the Greeks.
Okay, so, friend.
Yeah. So those are my legitimate fraternities.
Did you say Omega Psi Phi already?
I did say Omega Psi Phi.
Oh, dang. I wasn't listening. My bad.
Yeah, you weren't listening. You was caught up in
the sauce. I'm part of Q&L.
Q5Q.
I'm
fucking crying, bitch.
Q5Q.
It was the stutter for me,
Did you want to go to a HBCU? When did you first know about, like, HBCU?
Established 2017, Queens and Letters. I'm just kidding. No, but I have been bitch. No, seriously, since Tallie and I got together, this was a big part of who he is, like his whole college life and being a part of these fraternities and different clubs and such. It's made him who my husband is today. So I've been so intrigued by the Greek life, and it's so cool for you guys to have this sisterhood and brotherhood for forever. You know what I'm saying? And Q&L are just like in a whatever. I mean, I'm not gonna downplay what we have or whatever, but it's like less official.
It's essentially the same thing, though. You kind of you started your own thing, right?
And you guys' fraternities have been going on for years and years and years. So you guys have something to uphold. You guys
shout
have
out to the K's and the Alphas for paving the way, the first and the finest. You're an old foot going on. Do you have something to say, Tallie, over there? 1911, because 1908 for sure came before then. Oh, you wanted to get in this conversation?
We're in it, baby. If we want to be technical, FAMU Alpha founded in 1898.
So let's pull some protocol here, folks.
I don't want to do that. I would just like to still say,
what is going on?
This is just beautiful Greek rivalry. That's all.
So there's always this thing about like the oldest and the coldest, right? That's what they used to say.
Like who started the first and the finest is what you meant to say with a PH.
Yeah, we Omega Psi Phi was the first. Omega Psi Phi was the first founded at a historically black college and university.
Okay.
So there was, you know, just a concentration of depth and culture that just erupted and just made just this perfect thing.
Omega Psi Phi?
Called Omega.
Yeah. I ain't gonna lie to you because I do a lot of cues, so I was gonna talk shit, but then I was like, let me not, because anybody who knows me knows.
Yeah, nah, but it's all love. Like, when you're undergrad, it's fun to have the rivalry. It's fun to hate on each other. It's fun because you're representing. Yeah, until it gets real. But then once you leave the yard and you become a grad, you understand that everybody had the same purpose.
Okay.
It's about uplifting the community. Every fraternity and sorority does things to help the community, the school. They doing give backs for, you know, underprivileged people in the community. There's health initiatives. Mm-hmm. There's all sorts of things.
Different targets,
and then social life, being on campus, man, when you're in college, you got to unwind. Mm-hmm. You have to. You have to. There's some people that go to college and they never enjoy college. They're there for classes or whatever. You might as well be on an online school.
Right.
You might as well take class online. Oh,
right, right.
We provide, the platform.
So why did you join?
I joined.
That's what I was gonna ask. Let me ask the questions.
All right. So me personally, I joined, and it's funny, bitch, because my
you're
decision.
You're being interviewed, bitch.
Shut the fuck up.
No, I'm just kidding. Sorry.
Yeah, no, I want to know why all of y'all joined, and I want to know why you guys chose that particular, you know, fraternity.
So I'll be short.
Yep.
Starting off, when I played football, I was younger. So being from the South, I'm from Atlanta, Georgia, a lot of my coaches, my uncles, and stuff, they were Qs. You see the brands on their arms. You see them barking. Mm-hmm. Throwing, score
show
touchdown.
The brands. Show your camera your brands, honey.
I mean, you can see just a few of them. I got this one here. I have 10 total for
10?
0010,
yeah.
Baby.
Yeah.
Shout out to my line brothers, 0010. Y'all can't see the other ones. I might get in trouble.
Shout out to the Q.
By his wife.
But like, you know what I'm saying? Like, It's an energy thing. Every fraternity and sorority has a kind of like their own like stereotype,
right?
And that's just the that's the persona. Angle. It doesn't mean everybody's like that,
right?
But, who's texting us?
It's an email, bitch.
I liked everything about the Qs. I like, you know, just the Qs. Everybody know the Qs are loud. The Qs are brash. The Qs are confident. You know what I'm saying? Just the energy of the Qs, and that's what made me pick Omega Psi Phi early on, because I remember it from a kid looking up to those people, and then as I grew up. And when I went to the college, I looked up the purpose. I looked up, you know, who were the founders and what were the things that founded upon the fraternity. And I was like, you know what? This is pretty much in alignment with my ideals. So, and I like purple and gold. I wanted to wear gold boots. And I wanted to bark and stick my tongue out.
And I wanted to bark.
Bark, honey.
You got the levels right?
Hey.
That's just a baby bark. That's a baby bark.
Hey.
All right, I won't be long. That was me. Yeah. I wanted to be out. That was my question. That was
okay.
The
let's go to
question.
Jazz. Jazz, what made you choose the AKs?
I was gonna make sure you said it right.
She was like,
I'm a third generation. So my grandmother was an AK.
Come
my
on,
mother's
third
an AK. Okay.
Hey.
And then me. And I really appreciated the way that it was in my life. My mom didn't force it on me, but she was always around her line sisters. My godmom's her line sister. I would just hear their stories and see their relationship and their dynamics. My dad's also Greek. My dad's a noob. Kappa Alpha Psi. So Greek life was always around. They had like a Greek room with all their paddles and pictures. And I was like,
oh, yeah.
Yeah. And I was like, that's so cute. I definitely was not allowed in there.
Oh.
Yeah. My mom would be like, you ain't in this.
Come up out.
Yeah. And then when I went to college, she was very relaxed about it. I saw them because I didn't go to an HBCU. I went to a PWI, a predominantly white institution.
Wow. Wow. That's interesting.
So Greek life is very
predominantly white institution.
Different. Oh, my gosh. HBCU Greek life and PWI Greek life, night and day.
Mm-hmm. For real?
Night and day.
HBCU
the dynamics are
10.
So
yeah, no, I can imagine.
But a majority of... But
yeah.
A majority of the schools.
So for it was like not a lot of black people on my campus. So when I saw that, I was like, my people, what's that? That's cute. What y'all doing?
Uh-huh.
And then once I saw the AKs on my campus, their energy just resonated with me, and it was almost like all the seeds that had been planted just like just blossomed.
Awesome.
Like this makes sense. This is what I want to do. This is what I naturally gravitated towards. And my mom was like, cool. Do what you gotta do.
Yeah.
Let me know. I mean, there's a lot more.
Wait, okay, so in your chapter,
okay,
are you the only black girl?
No, we're all black.
Oh.
Not all of us. We have some mixed girls, Sri Lankan, but we black.
Okay.
We black. We rep that loud and proud. Yeah.
Yeah.
We're all minorities.
Is there white girl? Is there white girls in your chapter?
Not in my chapter.
Oh.
Not in my chapter. But
that's cool.
In the organization.
Do you think it would have been different for you? If that chapter was like, if you were the only black girl in your chapter,
it would never happen with some of the organizations.
What do you mean?
What
it would,
saying,
yeah. What do you mean? It would never happen
because they're historically black, and it's kind of presented.
It's like a token few
to be black
sprinkled in there.
It's gonna be hard pressed to find
to find like an all white situation.
Oh, you won't find an all white situation, and then not in a D9 fraternity.
Yeah, not in
a
black.
Oh, I see.
It's a few sprinkled in there, but to have the chapter be predominantly not that.
Right.
Yeah.
I honestly, I don't. It does change it.
Is my sound
in my
right?
opinion.
Mm-hmm.
And it's not to speak down on anybody who isn't.
Yeah. No. Minority, absolutely.
Because I mean, you still got to put the work in.
Yeah.
And if that's what you're doing, that's ultimately like Tallie was saying. Once you get off the yard,
armpits,
and you're
bitch.
Just. And you're in a graduate situation, you see the bigger picture of it. And I appreciate my organization and what we've done on a way deeper level now that I'm grown and not on the yard.
Right, mm-hmm. right.
But yeah, that's why I joined it. It sat very well with me. I fell in love with their energy and what they were doing.
Yeah.
But I would also say, I mean, if there's any younger viewers, do your research. Just because something looks cute, understand what their targets and their initiatives are and what they're...
Because each sorority has like a... each sorority fraternity has their own purpose, right?
I mean, essentially, we're all giving back to the community. And
they have a way that they do things.
Yes.
Right, right.
You have... the method. 4-year plans, essentially, is how you could put it in plain terms and what you're working towards for those 4 years. Like, how does that make you feel? Once I heard about the targets and initiatives when I joined in Spring 17, I was like, ugh. I cannot wait to actually put work in. Don't get me wrong. Like, I was like, I'm finna stroll. I'm finna be cute.
Yeah.
I'm finna be at these parties. Like, I don't, if anybody says they ain't do that, y'all some liars.
It could be chapter specific, too, because at one school, the cues at one school may be a certain way. Mm-hmm. And the first thing is the fellowship. Could I call these people brothers or sisters?
They're the ones I gotta put you through.
Or whatever. So that's an interesting dynamic, because a lot of people ended up pledging something different than like their parents or their because of the people who were at the university at the time.
I did. Mm.
You know what I'm saying?
You did? Oh, yeah. You said your dad's an alpha.
Okay. What about you? Why did you choose your fraternity?
I mean, well, originally I always wanted to be an alpha because legacy, my father, right, was an alpha, just at a different school. Mm-hmm. But my dad pledged alpha at a PWI and I was at FAM in HBCU. And so there was certain dynamics that even him... He didn't understand, like, a lot of HBCUs are not just going to honor legacy.
Yeah.
You know, they're not just going to put you on just because.
Oh, your daddy was, okay, yeah, so you think you're good?
Yeah. Right. And so there was even a struggle with him because he was like, well, you're doing all this stuff. What's going on? I was like, you kind of have to go through this phase of IGing, I guess. Like, you're an interested gentleman. I don't know. Tallie could probably speak on that a little more. But I became a part of every other organization except the D9. Right. So I was president of the music industry club on campus. Right. I was in a band, which is like that's a frat on itself. Right.
Right. Right.
And then I was in a percussion section. All right. Drumline, which is like an additional, you know, it's like all these little things.
Yeah. Those are all right? different.
Especially at an HBCU. And they treat everything like a frat. You know what I'm saying?
So, right.
But at the same time, too, when Find Me Alpha came around, somebody approached me about Find Me Alpha.
All up in your phone, bitch. Every time it lights up. Somebody, sorry. What?
No, one of the older brothers approached me about Find Me Alpha, and then I just felt like it was, like, one, the right fit at the time, and I knew it was something that I could be a part of, also leave my mark, you know what I'm saying, and also create a little bit of self-development, because I think for me, I noticed every time I went through a process of an organization or something like that, I got more life skills out of it, I got a better balance of, like, challenging myself, you know what I'm saying, like, with real life things, because... When you get out in the real world, it ain't no just go to class and go home.
It's okay.
Like, it's a lot more. Right.
A lot of space in between.
Yeah. So it just kind of, I used it as a way to build myself.
What you gonna say?
And with the whole going a different way from my dad thing, I mean, there's still graduate chapters, right? Mm-hmm. So it's like I can still pledge technically, right?
Yeah.
But I think I'm kind of beyond that space in my life at this point. But It's okay. Like, my dad basically sat me down when I was a kid and was like, there's three ways you can go. He was like, you can go alpha, kappa, or Q, and that's it. Mm-hmm. He was like,
I'm fucking not Iota? Crying. He said, you can't be no sigma can't be or no, no Iota. Sigma?
No, my dad, no. My dad looked me in my face. My dad looked me in my face. Tally, this is what my pops did. Yeah. He said,
banter. Right.
I will never forget this day. He said, alpha, Q, or kappa. He said, do not play sigma. And he said, iotas are not a real fraternity.
Damn.
My high school band director was an iota.
It depends on, like, coastal and region wise. Because I went to Atlanta and the sigmas was popping. I said,
they run fam.
What tends to happen sometimes too, though, is when a certain chapter that everybody wanted to pledge gets, you know, suspended or removed for other reasons. Mm-hmm. The people who were like, oh, I'm about to graduate. I want it to be Greek. I want it to pledge. Mm-hmm. What's the next best thing? And they'll go pledge whatever the next best thing is on campus. So a lot of the dedication isn't genuine. You know what I'm saying? It's kind of just like, I want to be a part of something.
Right.
And then
right.
It's more of us over here, so we lit. Mm-hmm. Right, or whatever. Right. I'm going to go over there because it's 40 of them instead of going over here.
I couldn't be no Delta. My mom was
but
like, don't do
eight
that.
Men thoroughly immersed.
Why? What's the difference? So, okay, so for a woman or for girls who are listening, I think there's only what the AKA and the AKAs and the Deltas are like the top sororities.
I won't say top.
Who are okay? Then what are the other? What are
she would say top. But she won't say top.
Bitch would say top.
What are the other female sororities? I mean, not female sororities. What are the other sororities?
SG Row.
And the Zetas.
Mm-hmm. Oh, and the Zeta. Oh, okay.
The Zetas are the sisters to the Sigmas.
Constitutionally.
Oh, that was me. My bad. My bad. I hit the mic.
Back to Ghetto Productions.
Right. Jazz, run the stereotypes.
No, the I'm sororities. Gonna get dragged. This is for the end of our shenanigans.
Listen, these are widely accepted stereotypes. These are not just something that she coming up with. I'll let you do the sororities, and we'll do the.
Oh my God, fraternity. My heart is racing, y'all. I'm sorry.
Take it with a grain of salt. It's just you know.
I don't know.
Why don't you start with the K's?
Oh well, it's self-explanatory. You see me.
I hate it.
I guess it is hard. Let me do the
okay,
sororities.
Okay, yeah, you do sororities all the time. Cool, because my chest was getting, my armpits was tight.
She was getting tight. She was getting tight.
What? Because you'll probably...
They're so comfortable.
Well, because
they're
comfortable.
Yeah,
your
sister was trying to be rude. Like,
if you give a disclaimer, they're still going to come.
I respect every person, and I will say that wholeheartedly, because I'm at a place where it's like, we're damn near doing the same thing. We're giving to the communities. We're here for a bigger purpose. We're serving all that. Now, the back and forth in undergrad, it does get spicy.
Yeah,
especially at my school.
There is the serious business community uplifting, run the chapter right, make money, boom, boom, boom. But then there is the fun side of it. You know what I'm saying?
It's real, bitch. A lot of people don't fucking like me.
Yeah, it is. So look, like, all right, I'll run the stereotype. So they say, since the AKAs, I'll
keep
run it first.
Do us right, Tally, because I will.
So things have evolved over time, but AKAs, they used to say, all right, you got to be light-skinned to be an AKA. Like, you got
to
have
Shout
long,
out to my
pretty
chocolate
hair.
Line sisters.
You know, they're supposed to be the ones that's supposed to have the long... You know, the AKAs typically have the long, straight hair, Ooh. Pretty nails, always done up.
I'm fucking crying.
The stereotype is that they're a little more... That people consider them to be more plastic, right?
Okay.
And not always in the bad way. Sometimes it's just like, oh, they're just like...
Bougie, high maintenance.
They just bougie, high maintenance. But in a good way. They just, you know... Boom, that's normally that attitude. Like, don't like to get
stereotype,
dirty.
Stereotype, because we
know
do
what
get
saying?
Hood over here.
Stereotypes. And then the Deltas.
Active beach.
The Deltas, they are known for being the down-to-earth, real sisters. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Ready to just, like, you know, they ride or die, no matter what. That's normally their...
Shout out to my best friend, Sydney.
Yeah, that's normally their stereotype or whatever. And then, like, let's talk about relationships and stuff. The AKAs normally hook up with the alphas, you know what I'm saying? Or it can be kappas. They kind of can go either way. The Qs and the Deltas are normally, you know what I'm saying, husband and wifey. That's what they normally group
Calm
us together.
Love.
Calm and love, you know what I'm saying? Those are, like, some of the biggest stereotypes. But then you know the stereotypes and, like, you know, like what's your perspective on the frat stereotypes?
I mean, we'll start with the Qs because Tally's right here. Just the aggressive, manly. They're known for being nasty, but I guess you could say like the nasty noobs. Like that's like a saying that
I've never heard that.
You've never heard nasty noobs?
No, never.
Cap. No, I've
never nasty noobs.
Maybe that's a West Coast.
They're
thing.
Like what the Qs are like the jocks, right?
Just very aggressive. They be
that's
barking,
a good way to
bitch.
Put it.
Jockey.
Yeah, the noobs are the pretty boys, very suavemente type of guy put together.
And what is that, the alphas or the cap?
That was kappa? The kappas.
Oh, kappas. Mm-hmm.
We don't really talk about sigmas out here. They're just...
What about the alphas? We didn't touch on the alphas. Who are the alphas? Like, what character are they?
Historically, nerds.
Oh, nerdy?
Black yeah.
Nerds. They're, like, so
they
informed.
Then they kind of developed and became, like... Little like more than that, you know what I'm saying?
I love me.
But they
some
were
alphas.
Always the bookworm.
They're more.
Alphas.
They're considered more bookworm, okay. More refined.
Yeah, just a gentleman. Just very, you know, like well put together.
Definitely. You could be all of that, honey.
I pretty much am.
Yeah, you're like all of that. Mixed
I could have
together.
Been. I could have been in any fraternity, energetically, but it's just like, you know, the people. You know what I'm saying? You know,
you got to go where you
connect
align.
With people.
Yeah. That's the biggie.
I was more
aligned
for Omega Sci-Fi.
Yeah.
All right, bitch. So where am I going?
Ooh,
you know, the funny,
you
where
the
am
funny,
I going?
The funny thing is,
where
I think,
am I going?
I think all three of us here know that if Aliyah was Greek, she would be the loudest and proudest in this room at all.
That
time.
Bitch would
oh yeah,
fuck
pretty much.
Out.
Yeah, I probably go off.
God, but look, I told her this too. I said you have to be careful because you're the type of person that sometimes don't make line because
oh,
it
yeah.
get
catty. True.
They'd be like, oh,
bitch,
you think
sorry.
You the shit?
That's funny as fuck. No, because I was
right.
Why? Why?
The way you carry yourself.
Because there's a thing. There's a such thing of humility, and sometimes people.
They'll humble me.
They'll humble you, and sometimes
I don't know if
they'll try.
And sometimes, you know, sometimes it's not always in the right way. Sometimes some people need to be humble. You know, you need to understand you're actually dedicating yourself to something bigger than yourself. It's a unit. It's something that we all doing together. But sometimes there's some people that need to be taken down a notch.
So does that bring us to the to hazing and stuff and all that?
Nah, we never. I don't even know what that word means.
What is that?
I don't know what that is.
Here's some secret.
How long this episode is?
Okay.
No, I'm just.
Where we at? Yeah, we got 5 minutes.
Okay, 10.
Mm-hmm. 10 minutes left.
Dang, that went by fast.
I think it's a little closer to like.
That's a
part of the alignment, right? So like, I could never really see you as like a Zeta. I don't think that's a part of your personality or your alignment. I could maybe see you as a Delta or an AKA, possibly. But it's just. It's the spirit. Like, I think if you kind of, like, you're talking about stereotypes, right? Like, no, like, for real. There's a lot of cues in entertainment, right? Mm-hmm. And to me, cues have always kind of been presented as, like, the people's fraternity. Like, fun, you know what I'm saying? They get all the work done, too, you know? Whereas, like, we see with Kappas, it's all about achievement and being presented a certain way, you know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
But it doesn't mean that the morals and all that don't align, but it's like Tally don't align per se with that. You don't necessarily align with SG Rose.
How would you like to serve the community? Would you like to serve the community with a suit on, or do you want to serve the community in your sweats?
Right.
You're gonna get the job done.
And still be in sweats, because despite what y'all may think,
I cannot. Oh
this
my god!
Leg and these Crocs.
If you guys are listening,
she's not a normal AKA.
Is that your leg?
Not an AKA.
That's her leg, folks. That's her leg.
It's just because like.
She's so extra, y'all. I cannot deal.
I feel like on a day-to-day basis, I don't dress like AK. Like, I'm not very the stereotype bougie prissy.
You know? Like, but you can be.
I've been told that I'm
right?
not
you can be.
A typical Q.
When I pull up.
Yeah, right.
Yeah. But in the Qs, we have the Omega Man, and then you got the Rudy Rude Q Dog. You know what I'm saying?
I
can throw on a suit. I can go and I can hold a conference on health initiatives for the black community. I can do blood drives and all that kind of stuff. But then I can go and throw on my fatigues, no shirt, fire up the grill, and feed everybody,
the
too.
The cargo.
You know what I'm saying?
What I want to ask, because I know we've been talking for a long time. I wasn't even keeping track. I really wanted to get into the process of, like, when you guys pledged. And I know there's like certain things that you can't say, but
you want me to tell you about processes?
I just want you in a word. I want each of y'all to give me a word of what your experience was before you actually put the letters on and before it was all official. Like, what was your experience? Describe it in with one word.
I got three words.
Three words. Okay, cool. What was your when you were pledging?
Hard but fair.
Hard but fair. Ooh, that's good. Isaac.
Because
I know you gotta put in some work in order for you to be identified as, you know, one of these.
Balance.
Yeah. That's how you would describe your experience?
If you ask me to say one word.
Three words.
Okay. Hard but fair.
Hard but fair.
It's hard to find anything outside of that. Be honest with you.
That's dope.
Worth it.
Come on.
I like that.
Worth it.
Wow. So anybody who is on their way to college and
dedication. I'm sorry.
Dedication.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I guess that's why
traumatizing.
I guess that's why
sounds
you guys are so
tragedy.
Proud.
Wood.
I guess that's why you guys are so proud too, because what you guys went through with the process. Like, you had to really work toward. You can't just get in there and be like, okay.
There is a psychological purpose to the pledging process. We don't pledge anymore.
What is pledging?
Pledging has been banned.
Okay. Yeah.
Rush. We call it.
Yeah,
but historically,
rush. Mm-hmm. We don't pledge.
Yeah. There's no more pledging. Historically, there used to be pledging, and that got painted into a certain light, you know, the things about, you know, certain things that shouldn't have been done to people. But there's an evolution, you know, people are evolving, and there's a different way that we treat each other, and there's a different purpose to the process, mm-hmm. and making a person feel like they've earned their space.
Right. And I like them that. Something I like that.
Put it working or not. That's what I like.
Because you ain't never going to let nobody talk about, you're not going to let nobody walk through your house with mud on their shoes after you clean the floor yourself. But if somebody else did it and the floor is never clean, it's, you're like, whatever. So that's the premise. That's the concept.
That was a good way to put it.
Yeah,
I really like that. I really like that, and I respect that of you guys. And I thank you guys so much for saying a little some, because I know you guys gonna keep it to yourself and
We have to consider our membership. You know, we're not in a single person chapter here.
So you guys would definitely, so to someone who is watching and listening, you would recommend.
Absolutely.
Yes.
You would recommend this whole.
I recommend
join something.
Join, yeah, right.
But I recommend they do their own research.
Yes.
Yeah. And do your research.
Do their own research.
Yeah. All right, y'all. And in order to be a queen, what do we call it?
Q by Q.
What's your noise gonna be?
Right. Ziggy. Ziggy Wong.
Ziggy Woo.
Ziggy Wong.
It's supposed to be cute.
We real up in this bitch.
I have a question for Tallie.
Okay, one more question for Tallie.
A quick question for Tallie.
Yeah.
What was more difficult, Family Alpha or?
That's a good question.
Omega, as far as the process.
Okay, as far as the process, Omega Psi Phi. As far as mentally, Family Alpha. I actually became a member of Find Me Alpha first. I had actually been through the process of other organizations by the time
I
joined Omega Psi Phi. So
you're like, I know what it is now.
Yeah, I had a sense of expectation and understood. And it's funny because some of my line,
helpful.
Yeah, my line brothers were younger than me, so they'll be asking me like, "What's gonna happen today? What's gonna do?" It was my job to give them the experience. I didn't tell them it's gonna be all right. You're gonna be good. I used to let them be scared. Let them be. And what it is,
that's what my mama did. Because
each person got to have their experience. I was like, my fraternities and organization I'm a part of had the depth that they did to me because of the process and the way it was
absolutely
delivered. If I tell you how the movie gonna end, you're gonna watch the whole movie with a different type of energy.
Absolutely. Yeah.
But if you're like, what's gonna happen? They win. Yeah, you know what I'm saying. So that's
how my mom didn't speak to me.
Yeah.
Good jazz.
Because she didn't want to ask too much.
Yeah, right.
She didn't want to know too much.
Yeah.
Because mama would have turned up.
My mom was like, figure it out. I'd be asking her, bitch, what the fuck? I don't know. Yeah. Figure it out.
Yeah.
Calling me Ivy.
So shout out to the bruh.
Shout out to all the organizations.
No, shout out to the AKs. We can leave it at that.
Thank you. If you guys are listening or watching, make sure to check out our other episodes. And I can't wait for sis to come back, bitch. I miss sis up in here. So shout out to
not enough?
You ain't enough. You too much, actually. You too much, Jazz.
She's a liar.
Next episode. So she could have been like, you know, because I'm the only one out of y'all three. It could have been 2 against 3. You know what I'm saying? Like, whatever. Make sure to check out the other episodes and make sure to go to Full Out TV. Y'all know what it is to dance during this lockdown, bitch. We don't know what the fuck is going on during all of this, and it's a nice stress reliever. So make sure to go to Full Out TV and check out all of the Queens and Leto's videos and tutorials because they're there. And type in After Class for a special little sum for from us. All right, everybody good? Any last minute remarks?
Y'all need to comment what organization y'all think Aliya would have been part of.
Yeah. If you know what they talking about, comment what organization you think I'm a part of.
Yeah.
I still really don't know. I really can't put my finger on it.
Because she's a hybrid.
I mean, I get that.
Of all the stereotypes. She's a hybrid of all the stereotypes.
You'll be honorary one day.
It would be the chapter.
You'll be honorary one day.
I'd have to see the chapter in the school.
Right.
I would be a hybrid, bitch. I would be all.
Yeah, see, you didn't make that line. She's not making that line. She's not making that line. She'll be the one to start her own, because...
Okay. If I said that to my pro fights...
They'd be like,
okay. Like, crossfit.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I'll probably make my own, to be honest with you.
Please.
Either way, I respect everything that you guys do, and I love it. I'm so happy that I've been exposed to this, to the Greek world from, you know, hubby over there. But anyway, so y'all have a good rest of the day. We'll catch y'all next episode of After Class, bitch.
I put my Isaac Carter voice back on.
Isaac, end us off. Say something.
Say bye. Just say bye. Or have a good day.
Oh no, wait, we couldn't hear. Do it again.
Have a great day.
Do it again.
What you want me to say?
Have a great day.
Okay. Hold on, I gotta try his mic. See, it's the microphone, man.
Come on, end up this episode, y'all.
Have a great day.
See?
Have a great day.
See?
No, there was a difference. All right, honey, cut us out. We out. We out. We out. Peace, all right, y'all.